Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Today, we're here in Pennsylvania taking a closer look at soil. To do that, I took my shovel, dug down, and I got a nice chunk of all kinds of plants and soil that we want to take a closer look at. So I took my shovel and I dug down into the top layer of the soil, and you're going to notice that the plants, they only seem to really be growing in the top layer of the soil. As I break this apart, put this one down, you can see the plant roots growing down into the soil, and if you look carefully, you can see lots of different critters living in the soil. I can keep breaking this apart, and here it looks like I have ant eggs right in my soil. Lots of different ants moving around. Those are the little eggs from the ants. And you can see them, they have a habitat living in the soil right next to the plants. So we have all these different plants living next to each other, and you can see how their roots grow down into the soil. It holds the soil together. But why would a plant send its roots down into the soil? Well, first, I think it helps to stabilize the plant so it doesn't just blow over. Well, second thing is those roots are taking up water and nutrients that help feed the plant along with all the sunlight that the top part of the plants are taking in. This top layer of soil is the perfect habitat for these plants to grow and thrive in. But I have to wonder, would we find different layers as we dig down into the soil? Well, let's grab our shovel and give it a try. And we just started digging down, and already I found a pretty sizable root. Looks like it's from a tree, and it's not just growing down, but it's growing out. So the roots are growing down into the topsoil, but they're also spread out. So we have our hole dug, and here's a slice from when we dug our hole, and you can see at the very top this dark soil, this dark band of soil, and that's the humus. And that's where the bacteria and fungus break down all the living material that falls down onto the ground. And then you see a slight color change into our topsoil. So when I pull this away, you can see our hole, and it's hard to see in this particular soil, but we have a dark band of humus up here, and then we go down into our topsoil. Now as we dig down, we start to find rocks mixed into the soil. And if we were to keep digging, and if we could dig deep enough, we'd eventually hit bedrock, solid rock. Right next to the hole we just dug is this beautiful blackberry plant. The reason we have these beautiful blackberries is because of what's going on in our soil. The habitat of this topsoil is the perfect place for our blackberries to grow. This topsoil provides the nutrients and the exact amount of water that these blackberries and these other plants need to grow. So right behind me and next to me, I have a wild rose, a wild strawberry, some honeysuckle, and all of these plants are getting the nutrients and water they need from the habitat in this topsoil. This is a sample of soil from Pennsylvania, but soil types are different all over the world. See if you can figure out what kind of soil you have in your area. Science is so fun, especially when you get to explore and get a little dirty while you're doing it. If you want to learn more about life science and habitats, check out our channel, Fun Science Demos. Thanks for watching.